In the last lecture, we saw high frequency model of BJT or pi model of BJT. In this lecture, we will see T model or sometimes called RE model of BJT, small r to the base E model of BJT. This is a simplest model of BJT, and according to this model, this junction is replaced by a resistance RE, and this junction is replaced by a current source IC. This is the base terminal, this is emitter terminal, this is collector terminal, and this is emitter terminal. Now the relation between this T model and the low frequency model or high frequency model is that in this the resistance RE is equal to VT upon IE. IE is the DC emitter current, and VT is the thermal voltage, as we have seen in the earlier case. This RE is sometimes also called alpha upon GM, and alpha is equal to beta upon 1 plus beta. So we can write this as HFE upon 1 plus HFE, because HFE and beta are the same. So RE becomes HFE upon 1 plus HFE into GM. This whole term is HFE upon GM. We know that this term is RB dash E or R pi. So RE becomes R pi upon 1 plus HFE. So from this we get R pi equal to 1 plus HFE into RB dash E. Now the calculation for current gain will be minus HFE, input impedance RI equal to HIE equal to R pi equal to 1 plus HFE into RB dash E. Sorry. This one is RE. And if it is unbypassed RE, then it will be 1 plus HFE into RE plus 1 plus HFE into capital RE. Third, voltage gain AV equal to minus AI into RL dash upon RI. This will be the voltage gain. Number 4, output impedance R0 will be considered as infinite. Now when RE model parameters are given, then voltage gain AV is equal to AI minus HFE into RL dash upon RI, can be written as 1 plus HFE into small RE. Now if HFE is large, HFE is nearly equal to 1 plus HFE, so we can cancel these two terms and the voltage gain becomes minus RL dash upon RE. So sometimes this equation may be useful. Voltage gain is equal to minus RL dash upon small RE. Small RE is the internal resistance, not the resistance RE. This is different and this is different. Now we'll see one example from gate It was asked in GATE 2008 electronics paper. In the following transistor circuit, VB equal to 0.7 volt, RE equal to 25 millivolt by IE, and beta and all capacitances are very large. This circuit is given. This circuit is given in the problem. The first question asked on this is the value of DC current IE is. Now, for calculating the DC current IE, we'll now perform the DC analysis. For DC analysis, all the capacitors will be open circuited, and if this capacitor is open circuited, this circuit will be of no use. This capacitor will be open circuited, this circuit will be of no use. This capacitor open circuited, this circuit of no use. So the for DC analysis, the circuit will be like this. We'll have 9 volt here. Now, for performing DC analysis, we'll replace this circuit with the circuit like this. We have already done this in the DC analysis of the transistor 2.3K, 3K. This resistance will be parallel combination of this 20K, 10K, and it will be kilo ohms, and this voltage source will be the voltage of this point calculated by applying a voltage division rule for this network, and it will be 3 volts. Now, base to emitter voltage is given as 0.7 volt. Now, we'll solve for this circuit. This VCC is given as 9 volt. Now, the current through this resistor will be base current IB, here collector current, and this will be emitter current IE. Here, beta is given large. If large beta is given, the problem will be solved by taking two approximations, IB nearly equal to 0 and IC nearly equal to IE. Without taking these two approximations, we cannot calculate this emitter current IE. Now, when we apply KVL in this loop, when we apply KVL in this loop, we can write equation directly minus 3 volt plus IB into RB plus 0.7 volt plus IE into RE equal to 0. Now in this equation, IB will be substituted as 0, so this term will be cancelled here. IE will be equal to 3 minus 0.7 divided by RE will be equal to 2.3 divided by 2.3 K equal to 1 milliamperes. So the DC collector current, DC emitter current IE will be equal to 1 milliampere. Now the next question on this circuit is mid band voltage gain of the amplifier is approximately, options are given as minus 180, minus 120, minus 90 and minus 60. Now first we will draw the amplifier circuit. This is bypassed RE, so resistance RE will not be there in the circuit. Now this is the detailed circuit of the amplifier. Here will be the input voltage VI and this will be the output voltage VI. Clearly seen that this is a common emitter amplifier with bypassed RE. And here the small RE model parameters are given, where RE is given equal to 25 millivolt by IE. IE we just calculated, so it will be 25 millivolt by 1 milliampere and it will be equal to 25 ohms. And we know that for a common emitter amplifier for which RE model parameters are given, the voltage gain AB is equal to minus RL dash upon small RE equal to minus 3K in parallel with 3K divided by 25 ohms. It comes out to be minus 60. Now we'll see one more example which was asked in GATE 2012. In all the three branches EC, EE and IN, the voltage gain AV of the circuit shown below is now in this circuit we are asked to calculate the voltage gain. Options are given: magnitude of AV nearly equal to 200, magnitude of AV is equal to 100, see magnitude of AV is nearly equal to 20, and option D, magnitude of AV is nearly equal to 10. Now in this circuit we are asked to calculate the voltage gain. For calculating the voltage gain, we'll have to first reduce this by using Miller's theorem. According to Miller's theorem, if there is any resistance between output terminal and input terminal, this is base is input terminal, this is collector, which is output terminal. If there is any resistance between input terminal and output terminal, this resistance can be divided into two resistances. First will be here, will be 100 k upon 1 minus AV. We will discuss about AV. And second will be this terminal, between this terminal and ground. This will be 100 k into AV upon AV minus 1. We'll call it as R2 and this as R1. AV is the voltage gain V0 upon VI, where VI will be the voltage across this resistance. AV normally is very very greater than 1. If AE is very very greater than 1, then 100 k into AV upon AV minus 1 will be nearly equal to 100 k. So R2 will be 100 k. So now we can replace this with 100 k. Now in this transistor, to calculate the voltage gain, we will require HFE, HIE are not given. So here we will use the RE model parameters. Here we will use the RE model parameters for calculating the RE model parameters. We'll have to calculate this resistance RE. Now first we will calculate this resistance RE. For this we will perform the DC analysis. For DC, the circuit will be like this. From this terminal, the current will be collector current IC. From this terminal, the current will be emitter current IE. And from this terminal, the current will be base current IP. This base and collector current will flow through this resistance IB plus IC. And this can be written as 1 plus beta into IP, because IC is equal to beta into IP. Now we'll apply KVL and this loop, considering this as a silicon transistor. And this loop, we will apply a KVL. According to the KVL, the equation will be 30 minus 13.7 plus 12 k into 1 plus beta into IB plus IB into 100 k plus 0.7 volt equal to 0. From this, base current IB comes out to be 9.9 microamperes. Now we know that IC is equal to beta into IB, and beta is given 100 into 9.9 microamperes will be 0.99 milliamperes, and IE will be equal to 1 plus beta into IB will be equal to 1 plus 100 into 9.9 microamperes, and this will be nearly equal to 1 milliamperes. Now we can calculate RE resistance equal to VT upon IE. VT will be considered as 25 millivolt divided by 1 milliamperes is equal to 25 ohms. Now the circuit for AC analysis will be like this. This resistance is 100 kilo ohm. Just now we calculated using the Miller's theorem, and this resistance will be 100k divided by 1 minus AV. For when we have this RE model in the transistor, we can calculate the voltage gain directly as V naught upon VI. This voltage gain V naught upon VI is nearly equal to minus RL dash upon RE equal to minus 12k into, sorry, in parallel with 100k divided by RE, and taking RE as 25, we get equal to 428 voltage gain, minus 428. Now here we have one more resistance of 10k. So if the source resistance is given, the calculation will be a bit different. Now this 10k, and here will be a source Vs. This will be 100k upon 1 minus AV will be equal to 100k upon 1 minus minus 428, and here will be the input resistance, which is one plus HFE into small re. This will be 1 plus beta is given 100, 1 plus 100 into 25 will be equal to 2.5k kilo ohms. Now this circuit can be again reduced 10k. This will be 233 ohms in parallel with 2.5k. The parallel combination will be, the parallel combination will be calculated, and the circuit becomes 10k, and a resistor of 213 ohms. Now the voltage across this will be equal to VI, and we know that VI upon VS is equal to 213 divided by 10k plus 213 will be 0.021. Now the voltage gain AVS equal to V naught upon VS is equal to AV into VI upon VS will be equal to 244 will be minus 428 into 0.021 will be nearly equal to minus 8.9. This is closest to minus 10. So the answer is magnitude of AV is nearly equal to